Passover of V14 of 4029, when the Most Holy was anointed. The blood of the Messiah was not poured out on the ground, signifying that he was an unacceptable sacrifice and the blood was to be trodden under the foot of men. Hollywood has fed us a picture that is completely unacceptable with God. What did happen? That is when the Most Holy was anointed, as Daniel spoke. That is when reconciliation for iniquity was accomplished. That is when the Messiah was cut off, not for himself, but for our sin. Now, we have to ask the question, why is it that the blood of Messiah was poured out on the ark at Passover? I thought the Day of Atonement was the day that the high priest would enter before the Ark of the Covenant on that one most holy day and sprinkle blood on the east end of the Ark of the Covenant on the Day of Atonement. But the Day of Atonement isn't until the seventh month, the tenth day of the seventh month, on Tishri 10. But yet, the blood of the Messiah fell on the Ark of the Covenant on V14 on the day of the preparation of Passover. What is the situation here? You have to ask it. Why? Because they are rehearsals. The Passover is a picture of personal redemption. God could have put the Day of Atonement at Passover should he have wanted to do so, if that's what he was trying to depict. But no. Passover is a picture of personal redemption. Those who put the blood over the doorpost and on the lintel, that household was saved. Those people were saved who were under the blood. And it is at that time that the Most Holy was anointed as a picture and as the literal reality that we were bought and paid for individually on that day. But yet there's another day coming, which will be Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement, on Tishri 10, 6001, and that is the day that is set aside for that new covenant that was made in his blood, when his blood was poured out for the remission of our sin, for that covenant to be confirmed. For Israel, at the end of the Gog-Magog war, at the culmination of that, when God fights for Israel and God reveals his power and reveals the testimony that he put in the earth of his son, that is the day that's set aside to confirm that covenant, and that's when the blindness in part that happened to Israel will be lifted from their eyes. That is what is going to shake the world. And these are the days that we are now living in, as what we have seen that we have been bought and paid for, and then exactly 50 days after the Bikurim offering, we come to the Feast of Shavuot, the Feast of Pentecost. And it is there at the Feast of Pentecost, which was the fulfillment of what John the Baptist had prophesied, that I, John, baptize you with water, but the one that comes after me, he will baptize with the Holy Spirit and with fire. And then we see that all through the Messiah's ministry, never once did he baptize in water. He came to baptize with the Holy Spirit. And being assembled together, as it says in the book of the Acts of the Apostles, in verse 4 of chapter 1, being assembled together with them, commanded his disciples that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which, saith he, you have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with Holy Spirit not many days hence. And we see that when the day of Pentecost was fully come, the Feast of Shavuot, they were all with one accord in one place. They were in the house of prayer just as they were supposed to be, and there it was that suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a mighty rushing wind, and it filled all of the house of prayer where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it sat upon each one of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. They who were assembled together upon the Temple Mount, then, when they saw that pillar of fire come down, the same pillar of fire that led the children of Israel through the wilderness, when they saw that pillar of fire come down and then cleave off onto each one of those disciples, and they were filled with the Holy Spirit, it came to pass what John the Baptist had prophesied and what the Messiah said that he himself had come to do. And it is then the fulfillment of the spring feast that we leave off in Leviticus 23 and verses 21, where it says that these feasts, which were all shadow pictures, committed to Israel's keeping forever and forever and forever, that we see that the spring feast then find their conclusion. And something has happened in the heavens just in the last few years that finally concluded this year on the feast of Shavuot. And that is what I would like to share with you now. Because in the heavens, we know that God put his signs in the heavens. And this sign that you are now looking at, this is the sign in the heavens, in the Hebrew, called the breaker.